Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. My name's Violet, and if you're new here, most of my videos on my channel are related to nursing school because I am a nursing student in an accelerated nursing program in Nashville, Tennessee. So let's go ahead and get started with this video. So I actually just dropped Campbell off at the airport. If you watched my last vlog that I just posted, we filmed a Zara try-on haul, and I think she did Nordstrom, and there was also Ulta in there. So if you haven't watched that, go watch that. But had my makeup done, had a cute little top on, got some coffee. Parlor Donuts, if you haven't been there, you have to go. So good, it's so cute inside. And it's like in downtown Nashville, which is fun. But yeah, so I was like, okay, let me just go ahead and film this video. I've just been getting like a couple questions on like in my comment sections about how I got into nursing school, if the prereqs are different from an accelerated nursing program compared to a traditional program, how I applied, how many schools I applied to, just like my application process in general. So I decided to go ahead and sit down and film a video for y'all. Yeah, also, sorry about my voice. Lexi Campbell and her brother, Rob, came and visited me for this weekend because I just finished finals. And they just came to like have a fun trip. And we went out 3 nights in a row. Cause you know, I've been in nursing school, been pretty stressed. So I was like, whatever, let's go have fun. So sorry that I sound like this. I don't normally sound like this. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, I'm in an accelerated nursing program here in Nashville. So basically the difference between accelerated nursing program and a traditional nursing program is that an accelerated program goes by a lot quicker than a traditional nursing program. So I'm not 100% sure because I didn't do a lot of research on traditional programs, but at our school, I went, did my undergrad at Ole Miss, and you could do like a 2 and 2 program through Ole Miss. You could do 2 years undergrad and then do 2 years of your nursing degree and then come out with your BSN. Or, and I think there's also programs that you can apply to where you can go and get your prereqs out of the way and then go to a traditional BSN program. But I graduated with a degree already in nutrition, so I had a lot of my prereqs already. So I was like, I don't really want to do a traditional program. Like, I kind of just want to do this fast pace, get going here so I can get out of school, get a job, and be a nurse. So I just decided, like, going into it, that I wanted to do an accelerated nursing program. Let me just start off and say this. An accelerated nursing program is very, very hard and very difficult because you're moving like this. You're taking so many classes. I would have like 2 or 3 tests 1 week. Next week, another 2 tests. Like, you have tests every single week. You're constantly doing work. Very, very fast paced. But we're making it through, we're doing it. So just going into that, if you're okay with that, if that's what you wanna do, definitely do an accelerated nursing program. There's also people in my program that have jobs, that have families, so anything is possible. You can do anything that you set your mind to. Anyways, with that being said, I feel like I just kinda rambled there for a second, sorry. But yeah, where was I? I don't know. That is my gist on accelerated nursing program. Also, some of the accelerated nursing programs that I applied to, some were 16 months, some were 2 years, and some were 18 months. I don't know, it just depends. So make sure when you're applying to accelerated nursing programs that you look up all the information, and I'll get into that later in this video. So like, once I decided that I wanted to do an accelerated nursing program, I started to narrow down what schools that I wanted to apply to. And I was being crazy, and I ended up applying to 12 different schools. And I think the reason why I just wanted to apply to 12 different schools was because going into this, I watched a lot of YouTube videos, did a lot of research, and applying to accelerated nursing programs is hard because you're competing with other people that already have the same like degree requirements as you. So that makes it pretty hard in itself. And going into it, I was like, I want to get accepted this term. I don't want to have to reapply for another year. So I was like, I'm just gonna go crazy and apply to 12 nursing schools. And I was fortunate enough to be able to do that because I was still living at home with my parents while I was working. So I was saving up all this money. And so I had money to where I could apply to 12 nursing schools. But I understand if you like, it is very expensive, like the application process, taking tests, if you have to take tests, is all very expensive. So just apply to whatever schools that you feel like you're comfortable with applying to. And I also watched a bunch of YouTubers going into this about their application process. And I don't remember her name, but there's one girl that applied to one school, didn't get in. Next year she applied to that same school and got in. And she was fine. I mean, that's her journey. That's what she wanted to do. Good for her, she got in. So if you only want to apply to one school, you can do that too. It's not, you don't have to apply a certain amount of schools, but I did 12 is what I'm trying to say. And I applied to 12 schools based off the actual program itself and where it was located. So I am from a very small town in Virginia, and I kind of just wanted to go somewhere I wanted to go to school somewhere where I could possibly see myself living after graduation. And I decided to do this because when you're doing clinicals, you're kind of also like selling yourself at the hospital while you're doing clinicals. So you're hoping that that hospital that you're doing clinicals in will offer you a job. So I'm just kind of like, if I go to school in Nashville, then hopefully I'll get a job in Nashville. And I just really wanted to be in a cool city, something fun, exciting, new for me. So I decided to apply to schools where I would want to live after graduation. So those were the two main factors when I was applying to school: the program itself and the location of the program. So once I started to do like more research, I found a couple schools I wanted to apply to based off their program and the location. And then I had to individually go in and research each school's requirements. A lot of the schools have the same requirements for an accelerated nursing program, such as like the sciences you need, the maths you need. Some schools required like a nutrition class, psychology class, sociology class, just like random things. But make sure you go in and check each school's individual requirements, because a lot of schools were different. And there are some schools that I didn't apply to because it needed a genetics class and I didn't need to take genetics with my degree. So I was like, I don't want to apply to these two schools because I don't want to have to take an extra class and pay for that. So I marked off a lot of schools not to apply to based off their degree requirements. And then there's also a lot of schools that required like different standardized tests. And I, at the time, didn't want to take a standardized test because there's so many schools that didn't require it. So I was like, okay, I'll just apply to those. And so I chose also not to take the standardized test. So that marked off a lot of schools on my list as well. So yeah, if you have any questions about the prerequisite classes or anything that you need aside from the classes, contact the school itself. All the schools I contacted were very nice and responded very quickly about the degree requirements, where to find them, if I couldn't find them, how they would send me the link to find them. But I would always go on the website first and try to like research as much as I can about the program and the school before I contacted the school, because that makes you look more prepared and it makes you look like a go-getter in a sense. Like, you're not just like taking the easy way, hey, what are your requirements, when they're already on the website. Just go and research that yourself, and then whatever you can't find, you just contact the school and they'll give you that information. And I made like a Google Sheets, I think that's what it's called. So what I did was I had all the classes that were required by all the schools I was applying to, and I checked off which classes I already had, which ones I didn't. So that also helped me narrow down what schools I could apply to and which ones I couldn't. So I made like a nice little list, I guess, to like organize all the degree requirements for each individual school. And that helped me a lot with deciding what schools to apply to and which ones not to. Now we're gonna talk about a little bit of the application process. So not only do you have to have certain classes to apply, but a lot of schools I applied to required you write a personal statement. And some schools, I want to say, required like 2 or 3 essays. So now we're talking about the application process. There's this website called Nursing CAS. Nursing CAS, it's all one word. And they have where you can apply to accelerated nursing programs, traditional nursing programs. They have a bunch of schools go through Nursing CAS. So if you haven't heard of that, look it up, because I want to say like 8 of the schools I applied to were on Nursing CAS, and it has all the degree requirements on there, all the information you need. But on there, you also have to write the essays. So I'm not really sure what schools required what essays. So there are some schools, fortunately, where I could just copy and paste the same essay and just like change the name of the school for each different essay. So that was nice. So I want to say there was a couple essays that you had to write, which is also very time consuming. So if you're planning on applying soon, go ahead and start working on your essays. Get a lot of people to review them and correct your grammar, because that really helped me when I was writing my essays. I can make a video on my personal statement and just go over that and how I came up with my personal statement. And I personally really liked my personal statement. I thought it was really well written and a great idea. So I don't know. Hopefully everyone thinks that about their personal statement, because if you don't love your personal statement when you're applying to college, then you should change it, right? Like, you're like selling yourself in your personal statement. Everyone that's applying to the program has the degree requirements, has the grades, has the GPA. So that's just a check for them. They don't even look at that. What they're looking at is your personal statement and what makes you stand out from everyone else. So I think honestly, for me, the biggest part of my application was the personal statement. And I really got not upset, but just kind of like discouraged when certain schools didn't require a personal statement. And it's just like they didn't even like care to get to know you in a sense. They were just like, what are your grades? Are you smart? Cool, you can get in. It's just like I felt like when I was applying to schools that required a personal statement, they cared more about the students and who they are as a person. So keep that in mind when applying to nursing school. And then so after all that was submitted, I actually had to do an interview for one school, and it was a Zoom interview because of COVID. It went really well. We broke off into groups, and I think I had like 5 or 6 people in my interview, and they asked us all questions. I prepared for that. I watched a bunch of YouTube videos on that and how to perfect my interviewing skills. So that was actually, I actually really enjoyed that. I ended up not going to the school that I interviewed for. I got accepted, but I did not go. I only had an interview for one school, now that I think about it. So yeah, just be ready for that too if they ask you to interview. Just go ahead and start practicing, looking at videos, have your friends interview you, have someone that you're not that close with interview you. Anything helps, any practice. And it's also just like if the school is interviewing you, it's because, don't be nervous. It's probably because that school really cares about their students and they want to make sure that they have the best of the best and not just who looks good on paper, but who has good people skills, who's personable, who is serious about this career and not just looks good on paper. So don't be afraid to interview. Don't let that hold you back from applying to a school. So now we're going to talk a little bit about the harder part and the more discouraging part of this video. I only got accepted into, let's see, I think it was 5 schools. I got accepted. Yeah, so I only got accepted into 5 schools and I applied to 12 programs. So there's that. I think the first 6 schools I heard back from rejected. I got rejected from 6 schools in a row and I was sitting there thinking like, oh my gosh, what is happening? I just felt so discouraged and defeated in that moment. And I thought that I was like, never gonna get into nursing school. I had no idea. Like, I just thought something was wrong with me. I felt so discouraged. I got rejection after rejection after rejection after rejection and so on. And then finally I got accepted into my first nursing school and I was so happy. And I was like, okay, I'm going to school. It wasn't where I wanted to go at all. Cause I was just like, I applied to certain schools that were just kind of like a backup school, you know, cause very important, apply to schools that you know you will probably get into and it's just at the bottom of your list, but it's a little safety net. That helped me a lot because getting 6 rejection letters and then finally getting acceptance, I was like, hallelujah, I'm going to nursing school. Don't care where it is, but I'm going and I'm gonna get to be a nurse. So yeah. And then after that, some more acceptance letters started rolling in. And then I wanna say I got accepted into one school and it was one that I did not wanna go to. And then I got an interview offer for one school. And it was still one school that I wasn't like too crazy about because it was so far away. Just not a location where I wanted to be, but I was like, it's a really great program. Of course, I'm gonna interview them. They ended up accepting me. Then I got a couple more acceptance letters and I was like, oh, we're good. I feel great now. But it was very discouraging at first. So if you're going through that right now, or you have been going through that, everyone gets rejected. And I think being rejected makes you a stronger, better person. My mom said a really good quote to me because I've been struggling recently in my nursing program. That's another story I'll tell you all about later. But what'd she say? Something like rough waters makes for a better sailor. Saying like, if you have smooth waters the whole entire way, you're not gonna be a good sailor because what happens when the rough waters come? You fall off your boat. I don't know, something like that. So it really encouraged me and I was like, all right. So I got a little off topic. I don't know where I was going with that. But yeah, if you're going through a discouraging process in your life, in your applying process, if you're actually in school and you're going through something discouraging, just know that in the end of it, you're gonna come out of it either way. The days are gonna keep going. You're gonna be a stronger person because of it and it'll make you a better person. Yes, it is very discouraging, but it's not the end of the world. Life moves on, you're gonna move on, you're gonna get through this. And life happens. Hard stuff in life happens all the time to everybody. You're not the only one. So just know that you gotta keep chucking along and you're gonna get through it. Because I've been there, if you've been there, we're on the same page. And if you haven't been there, then that's fine too. I wish I was in your boat, but you know, at the same time, I don't because I'm chuckling through my, okay, I'm just rambling now. yeah, so I got rejected from a bunch of schools and I also got accepted in several schools. So with the schools that clearly I got accepted into. I went through those and I decided which school would be my best fit for me. So that is why I ended up here in Nashville, Tennessee. And in my previous videos, I mentioned this. I don't know if you watched them, but Campbell Steele, my best friend who just visited me, she's gone. I'm very sad. Just dropped her off at the airport, but wish she was going to school with me. She's going to do so well. She's going to Charleston. She got into a program in Charleston. I'm so excited for her. But in my previous videos, I talked about how we were applying to the same schools because we wanted to go to nursing school together. It's a great idea at the time. I still think it's a great idea, but unfortunately, that did not work out for us because the one program we got in together, it was like 2 years, and we're like, why go to school together when we could each go to our own individual program and be done shorter, and then we could like start working together and live together. So we had to make that really hard decision and decide not to go to school together. So yeah, if you watch the videos about us talking about our nursing application process and you're wondering why we didn't go to school together, I don't know if I mentioned it in other videos, but that's why. But yeah, I try to sum that up as quickly as possible, and if I left out any information, just comment on this. I'll try to respond. But a lot of the questions I was getting on my previous YouTubes were, what prerequisites do you need? How long are the programs? And that's honestly, each program's different, so I can't personally tell you that. You just have to go and research programs that you want to apply to and what their prerequisites are, how long they are, how much they cost. There is a website, I'm not sure what it's called, but if you literally just Google accelerated nursing programs in this state, or say if I were to Google accelerated nursing programs in Virginia, a list of all the accelerated nursing programs would pop up. So that is very convenient. That's what I used to just go through and literally look at all the accelerated nursing programs and like compare them to like what states I wanted to be in and where. So that really helped me. And then I just went on the website and did my own research and wrote everything down. Very time consuming, very tedious, so make sure you have everything planned out. So I go ahead and tell you now, it's not easy, but it's so worth it. And if you're sitting here questioning like, oh, I don't know if I can go to nursing school, I don't know if I'm smart enough to do this, or if I can be a nurse, you can. Nursing shortages are everywhere. People are literally begging them to come to their hospital. You are going to be guaranteed to have a job afterward. You're going to be doing great things, literally making a huge difference in people's lives. And to me, that's personally why I want to do nursing. I just want to be there for people when they're in their darkest, hardest moments in their life. And to me, that's something that makes me excited to go to work. And yeah, if you think that you're sitting here questioning, oh, I don't know if I can do it, it's going to be so hard, it's going to be so time consuming, it is. Yeah, it's gonna be hard because nursing in general is a very hard field, but it's worth it. And if you're even thinking that you can do it, there's something inside of you telling you can. So just go with that gut feeling and just do it. Sorry, I'm just kind of rambling still, but going off on that, there was this girl that I was working with back at home. She was a CNA, and she just couldn't decide if she wanted to go to nursing school and get her nursing degree because she already had her CNA license. And one of her main reasons why she didn't want to go is because it's so long. It is time consuming. Sorry, my storage got full, so I had to go and delete some videos. But anyways, as I was saying, either way, 2 years is going to go by. So if time is holding you back, in 2 years, it's going to be 2 years. If you're 30 now, in 2 years, you're still going to be 32 either way. So might as well just do it. Don't let time hold you back. That's all I'm saying. And yeah, it's difficult, but don't let something being difficult hold you back because it's only going to make you stronger. And that's my TED Talk. Thanks for coming to it. I hope you have a great day, and I hope this video helped you out a lot. And if you have any questions, because I know this video was kind of vague, just go ahead and leave it down in the comment section and I'll try to get back to you. Thanks for watching.